Welcome students. In today's class, we are going to discuss about the rest of the endocrine glands that are present in our body and the secreted hormones and the functions of those hormones and effects of those hormones in our body. The gland that we are going to talk about first is the adrenal gland. The adrenal glands are located like a cap over the two kidneys on our body. So since we are having two kidneys in our body, we are also having two adrenal glands on the top of the two kidneys in our body. If we are looking at the adrenal gland to study its structure in detail, we will see that there is a central part of the adrenal gland and a peripheral part. The central part is made up of cells which are a little bit different than the cells that are making up the peripheral part. The central part is also functionally different from the peripheral part. The central part is known as the medulla and the peripheral part is known as the cortex. Now, since I have said that the central and the peripheral portion differs from each other functionally, the meaning that I have referred to is that the medulla secretes a particular hormone which is called adrenaline or epinephrine. It also secretes another hormone named as noradrenaline or norepinephrine. The cortex secretes another hormone which is known as cortisone. The function of adrenaline and noradrenaline differs from the cortisone in a lot of respects. The secreted hormone from the adrenal gland is adrenaline or epinephrine. Now, whenever our body encounters a stressful situation or an emergency situation, adrenaline or epinephrine is secreted and it prepares our body to either face that stressful situation or escape from that stressful situation. That is why it is also called the emergency hormone or it is also called the flight or fight hormone. It provides extra energy and it increases the heartbeat, the respiration rate, the blood pressure, the blood supply to the muscles of the limbs for escaping. And it also releases more glucose in the blood from the liver so that more glucose can be oxidized and more energy can be produced. Other effects that the adrenaline shows, it decreases sensitivity to the pain. Rapid effects last a few minutes or an hour because it is an emergency situation and not a temporary situation, not a permanent situation. It dilates the pupils to improve the vision in the stressful situation as well. From the peripheral or the cortex portion of the adrenal gland, the hormone that is secreted is known as cortisone. The other hormones that are also secreted from the different parts of the adrenal gland are given in the picture, like aldosterone and cortisone. Corticosterone are secreted from the part which is called zona glomerulosa. Cortisol and cortisone is secreted from the part which is called zona fasciculata. Estrogen and testosterone, which are the androgens, are secreted from zona reticularis. And in the medullary portion, we are having epinephrine and norepinephrine and some other hormones as well. The cortisone that is secreted from the cortex portion controls the carbohydrate, fat and protein metabolism in the body. It also regulates the sodium-potassium balance, that is the salt balance and water balance in the body. If someone is heavily dehydrated due to some reason, the hormone that is present in high amount in the body at that moment is cortisone. It is also helping the body to adapt to extreme heat, cold and infections. The next endocrine gland that we are talking about is called the pancreas. The pancreas is secreted just adjacent to the stomach and the liver like a leaf-like organ. Now, when we are referring to the pancreas, we cannot say it as a totally endocrine gland. It is instead it is called a mixed gland because it is having both endocrine as well as exocrine function. Why it is having exocrine function? Because we know that the pancreas is also a part of the digestive system, and it secretes the digestive juices that are part of the exocrine function of the pancreas. But the pancreas also secretes some hormones, which are secreted from the hormone secreting cells of the pancreas called the islets of Langerhans. So these are the endocrine part of the pancreas. The secreted hormones are insulin and glucagon. The main hormone that is secreted by pancreas is called insulin, and the insulin is a very major hormone that controls the sugar concentration in the blood of our body. It converts the extra glucose to glycogen for storage. It also induces the cells to burn the extra glucose for producing heat. It causes the cells to convert the glucose into fat. So, the insulin is decreasing the amount of sugar level in our blood. Now, if insulin is secreted in deficient quantity from the normal quantity in someone's body, we will have extra amount of sugar in the blood, and that condition is known as diabetes mellitus, where the sugar concentration is higher than the permissible level in the blood. Sugar is also secreted through the urine, and that condition is called the diabetes mellitus condition. It is caused due to under secretion of insulin. And in those patients, insulin is administered from outside so that the insulin deficient function can be matched up by the injected insulin. Another hormone that is secreted from the islets of Langerhans cell or the hormone secreting cells of the pancreas is called glucagon. Now, glucagon and insulin are antagonistic in function to each other. So, glucagon converts glycogen to glucose. So, insulin was converting the glucose into glycogen for storage in the tissues. Glucagon is transferring or converting the stored glycogen to glucose in the blood for energy production. It raises the blood sugar level in blood. So, the interactive function of insulin and glucagon is actually keeping the blood sugar level at a constant proportion in our blood and in a maintained situation.